Something I can help you with?
What is this place?
It connects to the sanctuary. Less flashy than the Saint-Chapelle entrance, but we own the building. Used to be part of our intelligence network. But the place has fallen on hard times.
How can I help?
I'll keep an ear out for any opportunities that come up. You might also speak to the Intendant about renovating the building itself.
I'm not exactly flush with coin just now.
Any revenues the cafe generates are yours to do with as you see fit. The money is deposited in the chest in the study, and the more improvements you make...
The more revenue.
Quite. You might also find that expanding our reach into other districts will pay dividends.
Merci.
It seems that workmen renovating the main wing found a small room hidden behind the kitchen. Its contents may be of interest to you.
Impressive, no?
What is it?
An heirloom of the Brotherhood. That armor was worn by Thomas de Conio.
I have no earthly idea who that is.
He led the raid that captured Jacques de Molay, broke the Templar's power in Europe for over a century. It used to be that an assassin who did a great service for the Brotherhood and for France will be given his armor in thanks. The seal that opens the vault was lost 200 years ago. It hasn't been opened since.
I can see why calling a locksmith was out of the question. Tell me about this seal.
It consisted of three rings, one for each of the three doors, but the seal was broken before it was lost. The fragments are no doubt scattered around Paris, with only the vaguest clues as to their whereabouts.
And if someone were to find all of them, would you say that he had done a great service for the Brotherhood in France?
I suppose I would at that.
Arno.
Welcome to the Assassin Clubhouse, Monsieur.
I assume these quarters aren't open to the public.
No, indeed. This is a private clubhouse for our brother and sister assassins.
Because belonging to just one secret society is passé.
Certain missions are too much for any one assassin to take on alone. In those instances, many prefer to work with the same team consistently. You develop a sense of each other's strengths and weaknesses, an understanding of what each will do in a crisis. Keeping a club makes it easier to organize such teams.
I suppose that's better than rousting whoever happens to be on hand.
Quite so.
Does it have a place in the revolution? And if so, what is that?
Certainly it does. It's a corrupt priesthood that ruins religion, not faith itself.
Well, but is there not a case to be made that superstition has no place in a rational paradise
of the
revolution?
I think rather that rationality must be put in service to faith, and faith in service to rationality.
Wait a moment. You can't think that we're going to let a tautology like that slip past.
What I mean is that we must examine our faith in the light of reason, but we must remember the lessons God has taught us as well.
Lâchez les bonnes voies.
Paris, September 23rd, 1788. Dear Arno, I never thought I could be so bored. Oh, Arno, what have you done?
Here for a fight, monsieur.
Come again.
A training match, that is. An assassin can never be too well prepared.
Isn't our mandate to work in the shadows? Stay undetected and all that?
Call this the fallback option. Better to practice here in safety than pick a fight with ruffians in the streets. No?
Touché.
Come for some practice?
Shame I'll never be able to tell anybody about this one.
Good afternoon.
The previous owners must have walled off a room in the main hall. Perhaps you'd be interested in what they found. That well's been disused for years. It'll be nice to have fresh water again.
C'est juste.
As new immigrants find themselves becoming hopelessly lost. The convention has approved the plan after a proposed alternative awarding each citizen of Paris a sack of breadcrumbs left 12 dead in a food riot. A theatre in the Marais district was closed last night after an actor took a heckling audience member to task. What the performer didn't realise was that the audience member in question was Michel Barrère of the convention.